Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome acclaimed rap artist and Grammy nominee, Tupac.
What people better realize is that this is not just play, I work.
What? Got it. Drag K off the stage. Y'all, come on, man. Do it for real, man. 1, 2, 3.
Whenever it's time for me to get down and do my business, I'm going to get down and do my business.
I can't get no blood on the set.
I believe I'm more responsible, more mature, and more focused.
You don't say me. You don't sing me love songs. Y'all don't bring us flowers.
When I was in jail, I couldn't remember why I was rapping. But then I was away from it for so long, I said, oh, I really like going into the studio. I really like creating. I like music, and I like acting. I like doing it.
She's a super freak! Super freak! Super freak!
I can be me, I can be whoever because I'm true to me. And the reason I sell 6 million records, the reason I can go to jail and come out without a scratch. The reason I am who I am today is because I can look directly into my face and find my soul. It's there, it's not sold, I didn't sell it. I thought, I'm a superpower. Death Row's a superpower. Let's combine superpowers and an ally.
Abu, my dog going crazy, ready to kill a few people. He want to kill.
Yeah.
I love my artists. I mean, I don't consider my people artists. I consider them family. It's just a big difference. If they decided to turn in rapping or singing, they still be my homeboys. We still travel together. If they need something, because mine will still be theirs. It's still the same thing. It's not no situation where I'm dealing with them strictly for business because they're good. Because they don't go like that. You gotta have a more, you know, respect for your people. Plus, you know, we got a Death Row East going on. Crusher, you heard about that.
Yeah, tell me about that.
Well, hold on. Damu! Damu! Sit!
But Death Row has a reputation for, you know, having sort of a thug-like mentality. I mean, wouldn't that get you into more trouble?
I think Death Row has a bigger reputation for success than anything else.
The reason for all the fear involves the world of this man, the man getting out of the limousine. 6'3", 335-pound Marion Knight, known by the nickname of Suge, short for Sugar.
It's an efficient camp over here, professional, business-oriented. I like that.
At the age of only 30, and with a lengthy criminal record, including 3 felony convictions, Suge Knight has managed to become the head of a $100 million record company and one of the most powerful and feared men in the American music industry.
The controversy over Death Row Records and its owner being sort of a gangster.
Everybody's asking about Death Row.
Suge ain't no gangster, man. He chillin'.
No?
Nah, man. Suge a rider.
I know what good morals are, but you're supposed to disregard good morals when you're living in a crazy, bad world. If you're in hell, how can you live like an angel? You see me surrounded by devils and you're trying to be an angel? That's like suicide.
I'd like to tell Tupac, keep his guards up. We ride with him. And one other thing I'd like to say, any artist out there want to be an artist and want to stay a star and don't want to have to worry about the executive producer trying to be all in the videos, all on the record, dancing, come to Death Row.
When I got out of jail, the West Coast, East Coast shit was really started.
Wait. The East Coast don't love Dr. Dre and Snoop Dogg? The East Coast ain't got no love for Dr. Dre and Snoop Dogg and Death Row?
West Coast was Death Row. The East Coast was Bad Boy.
Check this out. I'm the executive producer that a comment was made about a little bit earlier.
Everybody thought it's a war for record sales and attention and all of that. But to me, it was personal.
I love the East Coast. I'm from the East Coast. But then I felt like Puffy and Biggie and all them, they want to dirty up everything I worked for. So it made me come back more relentless. I'm mad at Biggie. I'm rushing the nigga. What's the problem?
Yo, Piggy, man, we got it going on, baby. It's on and crack it, man. He's gone, baby. You the man. You the man.
Son directed videos.
Pop, you alive? I mean, you safe? Man, I'm so happy you're free.
Yeah? Happy to see you. It's a lying piece of shit.
Pop, please don't kill me. It was Buff's idea.
No, man.
I'm just a rapper, man. Please don't take me out the game.
I ain't gonna kill you. We was homeboys once, Pig. Once we homeboys, we always homeboys. Even if you is a fat phony.
And I did a song with Faith, Biggie's wife.
Faith, my homegirl. I just want to send a shout out to Faith. Hey, girl.
Then I did hit him up.
That's why I fucked your bitch, you fat motherfucker.
Which is a classic battle record.
First don't fuck your bitch in the clique you claim. Westside, when we ride, come be quick with game. You claim to be a player, but I fucked your wife. We bust on bad boys, niggas fuck for life. I'm a self-made millionaire. Thug living out of prison, pistols in the air. Biggie, remember when I used to let you sleep on the couch and beg a bitch to let you sleep in the house? Now it's all about Versace.
You copy my style.
Five shots could drop me.
I took it as mine.
Now I'm about to set the record straight. With my K, I'm still a dog that you love to hate. No talk, I'll hit him up.
Grab your glass when you see two pop.
Call the cops when you see two pop.
Who shot me, but your pulse didn't finish. Now you're about to feel the wrath of a minute. Nigga, hit him up.
Everything happened so fast at that point.
West Coast.
But looking at things later, the East Coast, West Coast thing, it just got out of control. Dudes was getting killed, and I felt responsible. But I couldn't stop it.
We ain't mad at the whole spot of New York. We just mad at certain people.
I got this new project coming out along with some other brothers called One Nation, and it's like an East Coast, West Coast collaboration to kill this whole new vibe everybody want to be on about it being a war between the East Coast right. And the West Coast.
Right.
It's really just a problem with two rappers.
And the East Coast, West Coast thing is something that the journalists and people are making up just to get paid off and so it can drag out and everybody can have albums. They're perpetuating it so it could be drama. When it all go down, don't look at me and Biggie and be like, why is there a big East Coast, West Coast war when you're shooting this to 300 homes, 300 countries, telling them about an East Coast, West Coast war that they would never know exists. So that's where information becomes a problem. We both need to exercise greater restraint.
Damn. Sometimes life gets messed up. When I was on death row, I was successful, but not happy.
Tupac, your life has been marred by considerable pain. Do you think you'll ever get to the point where you can live a normal, happy life?
No. But I'm going for it. I'm trying for it. And until then, I have to make the life that I do live as happy as I can and try to do the best with what I have. Live the best life I can live, be as happy as I can be. Nothing is perfect for anybody, I don't think.
I felt trapped.
Now they say you made your bed, now lay in it. I tried to move. I can't move to no other bed. I felt I can't, live a different lifestyle. It's the life that they gave me. It's the life that I made. I felt I can't change. Not for the courts, not for the parole board, not for nobody. This is it.
I also just felt like something was going to happen to me because I'm paranoid. And I put it in my videos.
I've been tricking.
Where you at? No. Where you at? It was a prophecy. I had a prophecy about my death. That's why I like to go in the studio and do 3 songs a day. Get things ready.
We don't have time or the luxury to spend all this time doing one song. We don't have it.
If I die or whatever, it can happen. If anything would have happened to me, then I was ready to go. So it's all good. I felt as though the only thing that can kill me is death. And even then, my music will live forever.
Something we all adore. The one thing worth dying for. Nothing but pain, stuck in this game, searching for fortune and fame.
something we all adore. The one thing we dying for. Nothing but pain, stuck in this game, searching for fortune and fame.
Staring at the world through my rear view. Just looking back at the world from another level, you know what I mean? Just staring.
Approximately 9 p.m., security cameras at the MGM Grand captured Tupac, Suge Knight, and members of the Death Row entourage beating an alleged Southside Crip, Orlando Anderson.
Tupac, Suge, and others jumped Anderson, punching and kicking him to the ground. Terrified bystanders scattered as the group streamed into the casino, then out into the street.
Staring at the world through my rear view. Go ahead, baby, scream to God. He can't hear you. I can feel your heart beating fast. Guess it's time to die. Getting high, watching time fly. You know? Staring at the world through my rear view. Screaming to God, he can't hear you. Heart beating fast, time to die. Watch the time fly. Staring at the world through my rear view. Screaming to God, he can't hear you. Heart beating fast, time to die.
After the Mike Tyson-Bruce Seldon fight, Shakur, along with record company executive Marion Suge Knight, headed for a nightclub. But while stopping at this intersection, a car with four people pulled up and opened fire on Shakur and Knight.
Tupac Shakur was shot several times in the chest. The driver, his record producer, was grazed in the head.
He's returned to the intensive care unit tonight after another surgery, still listed in critical condition.
All week long, fans of Tupac have gathered here outside the hospital.
He's undergone two operations since coming here. He's had his right lung removed. He is intermittently conscious. Jesse Jackson's been here. Family continues to keep vigil. And despite early reports that his wounds were not life-threatening, people at the hospital here continue to tell us that he is in very serious condition.
At 4:03 this afternoon, Tupac Shakur was pronounced dead.
Who shot me?
Shit, I don't know. Sorry. Like that. It's a tragedy like Shakespeare, I guess. But I have no bad feelings. I have love for everybody.
Please welcome the mothers of Biggie Smalls and Tupac Shakur, Athena Shakur and Valletta Wallace.
Coming to grips with my past. It was hard. I don't feel like what I did was so evil. I just feel like the way I was living and my mentality was a part of my progression to be a man. But you grow, we all grow. We're made to grow. You either evolve or you disappear. I don't want to be forgotten. I'll always be a troublemaker to some people. But I still get love from my community.
I got love for my brothers, but we can never go nowhere unless we share with each other. We gotta start making changes. Learn to see me as a brother instead of two distant strangers.
I owe them everything. That's what I owe everything, to the hood. I got love there. I got love from thugs and the street dudes. And that kind of focuses me back on what I should be doing. Lay out the real map on the world and how it is. The message is, young black males can do anything if you just give us a shot. Stop trying to beat us down. And to my homeboy, we need to be in control of ourselves. I'm not saying I'm going to change the world, but I guarantee that I will spark the brains that will change the world. So keep your head up. Do what you got to do. And then inside of you, I'll be reborn.